Welcome to the fourth section in our series on the remarkable body, and this section is covering heartburn. First, I'm just going to go over some basic anatomy of the stomach, and I don't care that you don't need to know all of these terms. What I do want to point out is that the esophagus comes down right through here, and this is to the main body of the stomach, and then we're going to head into the small intestines over here. Right here, and it's not really shown in this diagram, but there's something called a lower esophageal sphincter. And it acts somewhat like a valve. So it allows food coming in through the esophagus, and it's kind of a valve opening. So the food will come down through the esophagus into the stomach, but then it's not allowed back up. It'll have flaps there, so it's not allowed back up. The reason I'm pointing this out is because some people have this natural relaxation of that valve, so it doesn't bind tightly together, and that means that the acid can leak up from the stomach into the esophagus. Now remember, the stomach has a mucus lining. The cells of the stomach produce this that protects it from that very low pH. Remember, the pH in the stomach is low because the protein is uncoiled or unfolded, and that's the first stage of step of protein digestion. When that acid goes up into the esophagus doesn't have that protective lining, so you get that burning pain. So that's essentially what heartburn is. It's a burning pain in the chest. It is nowhere near the heart. It has nothing to do with the heart, but you'll feel, if you've ever gotten it, it is right here. It's an intense burning pain. It feels like it's in the heart. But really, it's a regurgitation of gastric acid. Now, when people have this burning-like pain, what do they do? Well, generally when you have the heartburn, you take antacids. Antacids will neutralize that stomach acid. So what does that mean? It means it's going to bring the pH up. It's going to make it less acidic. So that won't be as acidic when it regurgitates back up into the esophagus. Well, what's the problem with that? The stomach is designed to have a pH of 2. It's going to produce more acid. So taking antacids is a quick fix that can actually make the problem worse over time. So what are some recommendations? Drinking water, fluids, whatever fluids, before or after meals. So you don't want too much in the contents of the stomach, because the less will tend to regurgitate upwards. Of course, fluids are important, but they don't have to be at the same time of the meal. Eating smaller meals is actually good. Limiting fiber, and I don't mean limiting fiber throughout the day, I mean at one meal. And particularly soluble fiber will expand in the stomach, so it's going to increase the contents of the stomach, pushing those contents up into the esophagus. Smaller meals more often instead of one large big meal. Loose clothing, actually, is, you wouldn't think so, but you know, after that big Thanksgiving meal and you sit back and you have to unbuckle, belt buckle, or unsnap your pants because your belly is so full. Well, anytime that you have an expanding stomach and you push back in on it, what's going to happen? It's going to go the path of least resistance. It's going to go right up. So wearing loose clothing will help. And not lying down after meals. Lying horizontal is going to have gravity bring those contents more likely to go into the esophagus. So not eating right before going to bed. And then if you do, sitting propped up with a pillow as you go to sleep, that would help as well. There are certain foods that have been linked to it. Generally, they say you want to avoid things like caffeine and alcohol can generally help. High amounts of sugar actually can create an osmotic gradient, and especially if it's taken without any other foods on an empty stomach, that can also irritate the stomach as well. So this is just a short section covering